Hi, everyone, and welcome to this Lightning Talk. So today, we're going to talk about real-time GraphQL with Prisma and AWS AppSync. More precisely, we will see how to use Prisma AppSync, a generator built for Prisma, to speed up APIs development. My name is Sylvain Simao, and I am CTO at Travis, a social platform for travelers where you can curate IDs and plan trips based on other people's recommendation. Now, apart from my work at Travis, I am also the creator of the open source Prisma AppSync package, which will be at the core of today's talk. All right, so let's jump right in. This talk will assume that you are already familiar with Prisma. And in the first part, we will see what is AWS AppSync and how we can use it with Prisma. Then in the second part, we will do some live coding and build an API from scratch using the Prisma AppSync generator. So what is AWS AppSync exactly? Let's start with a description extracted from AWS website. AWS AppSync is a fully managed serverless GraphQL service for real-time data queries, synchronization, communications, and offline programming features. Now, the most important thing to retain is what's underlined. In other words, AWS AppSync sort of is GraphQL as a service. But let's see how it works in practice. This diagram represents a common GraphQL API architecture. On the left, we have the client doing a GraphQL API request. Now, this can be the browser, a native app, or anything really. At the center, the GraphQL server, whose role is to understand the request, communicate with the database, apply some business logic, and return a response to the client. Finally, on the right, we have the data source. This can be a Postgres or MySQL database, for example. Now, there are lots of ways to create GraphQL servers, but two very popular approaches with Prisma are using Apollo server or using Nexus. Now, see AWS AppSync as an alternative to using Apollo Server or Nexus that you can also use in combination with Prisma. Now, there are a couple of advantages of using AppSync. First, we don't have to build or manage our own GraphQL server. Second one is we benefit directly from real-time capabilities, so subscriptions out of the box. We have access to a highly scalable and available infrastructure. And the final point I wanted to mention is we only pay for what we use. Okay, so we understand where AppSync sits and its benefits. So let's see how to set it up. To set up AWS AppSync, we need two things: a GraphQL schema written using a SDL syntax, and a resolver's mapping configuration. Now, in AWS world, this means mapping GraphQL queries and mutations to one or multiple data sources. AppSync supports various types of data sources, including RDS databases and DynamoDB, or, and this is what we are interested about, a Lambda function. Now, when working with Prisma, we want to be using a Lambda function as resolver, as it would allow us to write our own logic using Prisma clients. Time to see how to combine Prisma with AppSync. Now, assuming we already have a Prisma schema ready, the steps required will be creating a GraphQL schema. Now, this is likely matching our Prisma schema. So for example, if we have a post model, we want to create queries and mutations around posts. Then second thing we'll need to do is to write our code for the Lambda function. Now, this is likely where we're going to be using Prisma client to interact with the database. Now, we could do that manually, obviously. But here's the thing. All APIs usually require the same common set of operations: get, list, create, update, delete, etc. And we need to create these for multiple models. Now, writing the business logic for this operation plus creating our GraphQL schema is very time consuming and repetitive. So if you're wondering if we can do better, well, yes, we can. Introducing Prisma AppSync, a Prisma generator that will automatically generate everything we need to create a GraphQL API based on a Prisma schema. So now with Prisma AppSync, we can use the same file and data structure to also quickly iterate on our API. And because it is built using AppSync, we get real-time subscriptions, advanced security methods, and high availability out of the box. But I think this is enough with theory. Let's get to practice. So we have about 5 minutes remaining for this talk, which should be plenty of time to build a full GraphQL API from scratch when using Prisma AppSync generator. Starting from an empty folder, we will install Prisma AppSync starter kit with yarn create Prisma AppSync app dot to kickstart a new project in the current directory. If we have an existing project using Prisma, we can also install it manually following the official documentation. Now, when prompted, we want to give a name to our API, so I will use Prisma Day. Do we want to add a sample schema Prisma file? There is a typo here, so yes, because we don't have one. And I will pass my database connection URL. So I have already set up a Postgres database, and for now it is completely empty. While the install is finalizing, let's look at the files that come with the starter kit. So we have a Prisma schema with two models, user and post, and relations already set up. Prisma AppSync generator is there. And we also have the right binaries configuration to use Prisma on AWS Lambda. Moving on, we have a Lambda function handler. So it's using Prisma AppSync client. See this as a Prisma client on steroid. The function itself is quite simple. So we receive the event coming from AppSync. We pass it, we resolve the query, and we return the result of the API call. Finally, we have a CDK folder containing everything we need really to deploy our API on AWS. So next step now is to run yarn deploy, which I will explain in a few minutes. But for now, while deploy is running, we want to sync our Prisma schema with our database by running npx prisma db push. So I've just added at the beginning my database URL so that it worked properly. Okay, so let's have a look on table plus to see that we have our two tables that have been created with all the relevant fields and obviously following our Prisma schema. Okay, so back to VS Code. Deploy is still running, so let's look at what's been generated from the yarn deploy command. We now have a GraphQL schema that is ready for AppSync. So again, matching our Prisma schema. We have a resolvers mapping config necessary for AppSync as well. And we have a documentation. So for example, here we can see how to use our API for the post model. Finally, we have a Prisma AppSync client that will be used by our Lambda resolver function. Okay, so deployment is finished. Time to try our newly created API. In the AWS console, I'll refresh and we can see our new Prisma Day API project. So let's open it and let's go inside schema. So this is our live API schema, again, matching our Prisma schema. If we go in data source, we can also see our Lambda function resolver that's been set up for us. Now let's go to queries and let me clean the editor first and show you the docs. So we see we have a couple of queries that are available for us. So get user, list users, and same thing for posts. We also have mutations, create, update, upset, delete, and we have subscriptions for real-time events happening around our data. First thing we'll try is create a new user with some email and role data. Execute it. Okay. Now that we have a user created, we will create a new post. Now, because Prisma AppSync follows Prisma client conventions, we can directly connect the post to our previously created user via its email address. Okay, the first post is ready. Let's create a second one. Second post is ready. Let's try to list all our posts and get back the title and the author. So we have an array that is returned with two records, first post and second post, with the associated author. Finally, we will try something more advanced and query all the posts, filtering by a specific author email, so author email equal, and then we will use pagination to skip the first result and take only a single record. And this is what we can see. We have the right thing appearing on the right with only one post return, and that is the second one that we have created. All right, so back to slides. As promised, we have created a fully working GraphQL API in less than 5 minutes. And that was solely based on a Prisma schema file. Now, in the demo, I only had time to show you the basics of Prisma AppSync, but note that you can do much more. So, for example, it gives you a way to extend the CRUD API, creating some custom resolvers. And it also allows you to use some advanced security mechanism, such as authorization that you can plug in with Cognito, as well as fine-grained access control. Now, if you want to try the generator yourself, you can find Prisma AppSync on GitHub at maoc, so my username, / Prisma AppSync. The generator is not ready for production yet, though it is already powering Travis that you can see on the right, which I also invite you to check if you enjoy travel and would like to discover some cool places around the world. All right. Thank you very much for listening. And I hope you enjoy the rest of your Prisma day.